So we've been walking around the campground on the loop that we're camped on, just checking out the other teardrops. And that's one of the cool things about a TearJerkers meetup, is that throughout the day, they'll walk around and see each other's campers. Some of them are home built, some of them are factory manufactured. Some of them aren't even teardrops, they're converted cargo trailers or more standard campers.
Or vans.
Mm-hmm. And that's the cool thing about the TearJerkers, is there's a variety of different campers and you can learn a lot of things from each other. The stories that are told, and I mean, we just spent 3 hours looking at two different campers, you know, we just got talking to people. So that's the good thing about the TearJerkers. You gotta check out your local chapter. This gathering was hosted by the Tennessee VolunTears chapter of the TearJerkers. It took place at the Harrison Bay State Park on Lake Chickamauga, just north of Chattanooga. It was the perfect backdrop for a great weekend with friends. Now, I have seen one of these little campers behind me before, but I've never seen one up close. So tell me who we are or what we've got here.
Jim and Tina Darling, we're from Lafayette, Indiana.
Okay.
And we come down here and go camping every year, or we come down here for vacation.
Uh-huh.
This year we come camping.
And what kind of camper have you got?
This is a Sunray 109.
Okay.
And we've enjoyed it. We've had it since November.
Where are these made?
In Shipshawana, Indiana.
So on a previous episode, we actually drove through Shipshawana and I saw the Braxton Creek Bushwhacker factory, but I didn't know there was another tiny camper factory. So they must be like a tiny camper.
Oh, it's a mecca up there to make campers up there. Yeah.
Well, this is a good looking thing on the outside. I love this corrugated looking metal. It's got that real retro look to it. So if you don't mind, show us this thing.
The bed pulls out in, it's in a couch now and it pulls out in a bed.
Okay.
And it's wired for everything inside. It's got a hot water heater. It's got everything in it. So we take outdoor showers. We've set up a little shower and everything.
Really? What size is the bed?
It is a full size.
Full size
bed.
Okay. So, do you know how much it weighs?
1,100 pounds.
That's pretty light.
Yeah, it's pretty light.
I bet it tows well.
And I tow with that little bitty car. So.
Okay. All
and right. We came 9 hours here. So.
Is that your radio?
Yeah, that's a stereo there. So, and it you can do Bluetooth. You can do all the above, and then it's got indoor outdoor speakers,
and you can select between.
Yep.
Okay, so you've got your air conditioner over there, you've got your television, and what is this on the right?
DVD player.
Okay.
Yep.
So I found an app on my iPhone that you can point the camera at something and tell how tall it is. Let's see how tall this thing is on the inside, because I still have a little bit of headroom when I'm sitting on the couch. Set the first point with the plus key. Set the second point. And there we have it, 4'5" tall. All right, so that's my nerd experiment for the day. And hey, you've got a galley on the back.
Yes, sir.
I didn't realize it had a galley.
Yep.
That's a deep galley as well. So what all do you have in there?
So we used to have a microwave. So we took it out for storage because we didn't use the microwave very much. It's got a full fridge with freezer, works great. Actually, I had to turn it down even. And then we got storage, you know, up here and down here.
Look at how deep that is. That's such a deep countertop. That is nice. So you've got something that I'm getting ready to put on mine. You've got something set over the sink to give you more countertop space. I'm getting ready to do that on my teardrop.
Well, this one was kind of unique because you can buy it off Amazon and you can adjust it so it'll pop
really?
Right in there. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, look at that.
So you just adjust your legs, your little feet, and then it just pops right in.
I always say I'm going to steal something when I'm in a TearJerkers event. Check out that little sink plug. So it's got adjustable. I didn't even know that was a thing.
Tina found it on Amazon and thought it'd be great. It's worked out great.
That was worth the walkthrough just to be able to see that little sink topper. That was wonderful. So, hey, this is a beautiful, beautiful teardrop. Thank you so much for the tour. And it was good meeting you, by the way.
Yes, sir. It was great meeting you. I watch your videos all the time. So
appreciate that. So one of the things that you do at a TearJerkers rally is you keep your bed made up during the daytime so you can leave the doors open, people can walk around, look at your camper.
That's one of the cool things is we like to check out each other's rig and share ideas. So you always want to spruce it up after you get up in the morning and make it presentable. So here's another tip. We take a pint jar, we call it a mason jar, throw our eggs in there, and when it comes time to make them, if we want them scrambled, we just shake them up in the jar, and then they're ready to pour in the skillet. So let me tell you, that's one of the hottest things I've ever seen, is my wife throwing scrambled eggs on the cooktop of the camp easy.
I thought that was bacon.
Yeah, bacon's pretty hot too.
So we're walking around the campground here at the TearJerkers Rally, and I see this little silver Homebuilt camper. It's drawing a lot of attention. And who have I got here?
Glenn Perry from Poland, Maine, my wife Karen.
And did you hear that? They're from Maine, and this is a Tennessee TearJerkers gathering, so they've put some miles on this thing. So now you built this yourself.
Yes, sir.
And what year, how long have you had it?
I've had it since 2014.
2014.
Took, we've had 7 years with it, and it's been fabulous.
And what's the weight? Do you know what the weight
it's
is?
It's 920 pounds empty.
So this thing is super light. What kind of frame did you start with?
I started with a Northern Tool frame.
Northern Tool,
it's very,
okay.
It's bolt together. It's really simple to put together, and it tows great down the highway.
Sweet. Well, I'd say let's take a walk around this fella.
This was almost an afterthought. I was going to put a battery box on the front, but I had some extra material, so we keep our spare tire in here. We've got some small chairs. I will have the battery in here. I don't have it currently on this trip. And any other of the accessories that we camp with, charcoal, lighter, fluid, and the lid just pops right on. The doors, we have awning windows so we can keep them open in the rain.
Where did you buy your trim?
I got that from a gentleman named George. He's in Montana. And came in a tube, about $700 worth of trim. It's dead soft aluminum.
Yep.
It all went on pretty well. These look like rivets, but they're actually about inch long spiral nails.
Okay.
It's all sealed with silicone, and it's done well. We have had no leaks at all.
Perfect. Yeah. I just love where it's all silver. That's just got a real classic look to it.
Yeah, thanks. We appreciate it. It's 3003 aluminum. I originally wanted to build it with 5052. I couldn't find the material, so we went with 3003 alloy. We got the inside. We got about 6 inches of memory foam. We've got under bed storage. I keep hiking gear or any of the things that we don't really access too much. The walls and the floor are constructed with 1/2-inch plywood, and the partitions and the structural members are 3/4-inch.
Okay.
I think I've got 3/8 on the roof and 1/4-inch to finish off on the inside. The wall construction goes 1/2-inch plywood, 3/4-inch pine. In that, I've got some 3/4-inch insulation, and then 1/4-inch plywood. It's actually the B side of the plywood. I got it all at a big box store, and we like the grain better, so I finished it with Minwax Helmsman.
Yep.
Oil base. And online, we just purchased the awning windows online. We got the hardware online. It was a good project.
So what have you got going on in the galley here?
We've got some cabinetry here. It's at a 3/4-inch for structure, side to side. I got a WIFCO power center. I thought it was kind of nice to, I screwed these in so they're removable.
Okay.
And so I can alter the, if I wanted to add some more electronics to it, then I can get into the wall right there.
Did you make the 10 panels?
That's my wife, Karen.
Cool.
She's the one that did all that.
Well, that's a nice touch.
That's her handiwork. I think the upgrade, I'd like to put some struts on eventually. But it's pretty basic. That's the way we wanted it. We're going to run with an Arctic cooler, I think, in the future. And as far as support in the back, we just use a scissors jack. Once I level it off, when I pone to a site, I got a very small level, and I set it down on the door frame and just get it leveled off, and I snug it up on the back, and it keeps us stable. It's worked real well.
So one of the things I like about this camper is it's got a real classic look to it, being the shiny aluminum all the way around. And the woodwork on the inside is a real clean look. Got plenty of countertop space back here in the galley. So I think this is a nice little build, and I really appreciate you showing it to me.
Well, thanks for stopping by.
All right. So like I said, the TearJerkers rally is not just for teardrop campers. It's, you know, you're gonna see teardrop campers, but you're gonna see a variety of small campers and unique campers. And this is a tow light that we happened to pass, which is kind of interesting in that, as I understand, you bought this thing brand new.
It's a 1995.
And,
We looked at some used ones, and we just happened, went to the dealership and saw that and new, and we just liked it. It's the right size. It's a 21 but 18 foot box. Okay. And for two people it works perfect.
And tell me who you are.
I'm Howard Weller, and I'm here with my wife Luann.
Now here's the funny thing. When I saw this guy, I knew immediately that I had seen him somewhere before, and I could not think of him. When we got to talking, it turns out we've been going to the same radio controlled airplane flying for like 20-25 years. So we had some good stories around the campfire last night. But we'll show you just a couple shots of this camper. And this is a real beauty. And oh, hey, look at this pickup truck. Look how this thing's been taken care of. This is the kind of guy you want to buy something from if he'll ever sell it. So hey, one of the cool things about a TearJerkers rally is some folks will drop by to get ideas for their own build. Tell us who we've got here.
My name is David Denning. I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee.
And you've started your own build.
I started what, about a month ago, and today is the first day I've ever seen one up close.
How awesome is that? So hopefully the next TearJerkers rally we'll have him on the video showing his camper.
That's my plan. I'm retired now, so I don't have any excuses to, except for my wife's honeydew list that's a mile long.
But. Actually, I just found out that I live close enough to him. I might just drive to his house and go do a walkthrough of it.
Oh, man, that'd be awesome.
All right. Well, hey, it was good meeting you, man.
Wow, they were really good.